Well, it's time for us to talk fashion this morning, and we all know that denim jeans is a fashion favorite. It's a staple in so many of our wardrobes. The question is, why do so many of us get it wrong? Why do we choose the wrong jeans for our body type? And is there actually a science to our denim? Well, this morning, Expresso's fashion editor Nick Strelitz joins us in our how-to segment for how to get your jeans right, and of course, put you on the straight and narrow.
Straight and narrow.
How are you, darling?
Good to be. Good. How are you?
I'm very, very good, and I'm so happy we're talking about this because I see so many people getting it wrong on a daily basis, but what exactly goes into picking the right jeans for your body type?
Jeans are tricky, yes, because it's really the hardest working item in anyone's wardrobe.
True,
you know,
story.
On the day-to-day, we wear them so often.
Yeah.
So it makes it even more important that we get the fit right. I sort of have it down to sort of three Fs. So it's sort of fabric, fit, and size. I know that's not an F.
Fabric, fit, and size. Yeah,
well,
I was wondering about that.
Better.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's two F's and an F.
You
Sorry.
Lied. You tricked us.
Sorry.
Okay, so you've brought three different jeans here. Do you want to take us through what you've got?
Yeah, absolutely. So the first jean I have is when identifying body type, that's sort of the rule number one. So there's five general body types that we sort of all sort of go by internationally. So I've narrowed down to three, and you can see them up here, Lee. We've got the rectangle, triangle, hourglass, inverted triangle, and round.
Okay.
So I'm gonna focus on just three in particular, three of the most commonly found.
Fantastic.
First is the pear shape. And the pear shape generally is sort of
bottom heavy.
Bottom heavy and narrows up to the top, right?
Yes.
And you might not have the bust actually to balance those with the big booty. So all the focus is there.
Okay.
So what you want is a boot cut.
A boot
cut? Yes, I said it.
Oh,
a boot cut.
Okay.
It's coming back.
Oh,
in
I
a big
see.
Way.
Okay.
So what you really want to do is sort of this excess here at the bottom offsets the eye,
balances
focusing right
out
on the butt, and creates a fluid line from sort of top to bottom.
Very nice.
Really nice.
Okay.
The second jean we have is the high-waisted skinny. Now, this is perfect for the hourglass figure, the curvy.
Right.
The Kim K.
Hello.
The Kimmy K.
Nice.
Look at her go. So what you want for this, you want a high waist here because you've got, again, a lot in the booty.
Yes.
You need something with a strong waistband that you find in a high waist to keep everything in, yes? Also, pocket placement is really important. So sort of, if you've got a bigger booty, you actually want bigger pockets.
Yes.
Yes? Because that takes the focus away from the butt in general to
and
the pocket.
It on the pocket. Okay.
So it leaves it more excess on the, sort of on the end.
I love that.
The last one I have here, which I'm gonna come over here, is the boyfriend.
Oh.
Yes? The low-rise boyfriend. Now
this
is perfect for the inverted triangle.
Okay.
That's a mouthful,
which
I know.
Broader
on the top,
smaller at the
and
bottom.
Comes down in. So here again, it's about balancing sort of the narrowness from the waist down with sort of the broadness on top.
Okay.
A straight boyfriend will do that.
All right.
Yeah?
Very cool.
Yeah.
Okay, Nick, three tips for getting it right. Now that we've discussed body shape, what are the three tips for the fit?
Three tips, so size is just as important as the body type. It's the most important thing, I think. You can get your body type, but if it's not the right size, you're gonna suffer.
Okay.
I have a three rule test.
Okay.
And I need your help with this.
Yeah.
Rule number one is, okay, can you stand up to the side? Can you stand?
Okay.
You don't want any excess where the sort of underbutt reaches the upper thigh.
Yeah.
You don't want to be able to grab any excess fabric there. So you can see yours is lying really flat
and smooth.
Oh no,
I'm fold out, honey.
You got that
smooth booty, girl. There's no space for nothing. Okay.
I got lots of, don't look at mine. The second rule, okay?
Yes.
So once you've got the underbutt test rule, you want to buy a size smaller than you actually are.
Okay.
Too often our jeans stretch with wear.
Yeah.
And you want to get longevity out of them. So
yes.
Buy a size down. Even if it's super, super tight and uncomfortable, if you can get the last button up, you're fine.
You're good.
You're good
to go.
Yeah.
And then number three?
Oh, number three. So yeah, so we've got the underbutt test. It's the two-finger test here.
Okay.
So it's not as dangerous as it sounds, everyone. So here where the waistband is here, you don't want to be able to fit more than two fingers in this side.
In here at the bottom.
So if you fit three or four, like you can in mine, it's the wrong size down.
All right. So
two fingers.
How have you broken your own rules, mister?
Well, I'm the exception to the rule.
Mr. Squarepants. Thank you so much, Nick,
You're welcome.
Being here and, of course, showing us how to, A, pick the right jeans for our body type and, of course, those tips for fit. Oh, what would we do without you?
Oh, nothing.
Listen, you're perspiring. Now that you touched my booty, you're perspiring. We're
going to
take a quick break. We'll be right back after this. Really? It's my feel-good breakfast show. Oh, well, listen, it's that time of the morning for us to take a look at the Expresso How-To Fashion Guide. Well,
Well, it's time for our how-to fashion guide, and it's all about offering substantive style advice. It is easy to use and fashionable to a T. And in today's installment, we're talking three ways to wear, and it's your guide to getting maximum bang for your buck and yet ensure you're spending your money wisely. We have Expresso Fashion editor Nick Strelitz.
Hi,
Zo. I'm very excited for this because every girl has a little black dress.
Every girl, including me.
Everyone should have a little black dress.
Everyone should have a little black dress, but even more importantly, I think what's important about this series is offering style advice to viewers, but saving while doing it at the same time.
Yes.
Style and savings are not mutually exclusive terms.
No, because when I buy a dress, I always think of how can I get the most use out of this dress?
Absolutely.
Without being like, oh, she's wearing that dress again.
100%, and times are tough, and we want our wardrobe to really go the distance.
Yes.
So that's what I'm doing today with the low back dress.
So what is our first little pointer?
Yes. So we're doing three ways to wear. So First I'm talking the work week little black dress.
Okay.
And here we have Wawa coming out. So Wawa's wearing the little black dress, but I've got it on with a structured blazer.
Okay.
So again, it's about mixing sort of quintessential office pieces, but giving them a much needed update. So rolling up the sleeve a little bit.
I have to ask, growing up, I always got told never wear navy and black together. Is that still a no-no?
Like,
is that
not.
Still old school?
Otherwise, I will be ejected off of the show because I love navy and black.
Okay.
I hope other people do as well.
Okay.
Anyway, she's got the functionality with the big bag, so it's functional. She can put her papers, everything she needs, but she looks modern.
I love that she's wearing it with the brogues because you can also pair this with, heels, a boot.
I'm thinking comfort, so I'm thinking
you're thinking on your
feet for 8, 9, 10 hours.
Okay.
Why not do a flat and a brogue? That detailing there, the beautiful detailing of the toe, just gives it something extra.
Yes.
It's all about extra.
I love that.
Extra.
Okay,
yes.
What is our next look? Because did you say this is workwear?
So this is work.
This
is workwear Monday to Friday.
Okay.
Now we're doing, it's the weekend. We are going out.
Yes.
And we are showing our style. So during the weekend, it's all about street style. So this is for the quintessential street style woman.
Mm-hmm.
And what says street style better than denim?
Yes.
Denim on denim. Is there more denim?
No,
that's it.
Just two layers.
We've got the sequins cap. So again, we're using the little back dress. It's the focal point, but this is really about that coolness. We want to look like she's coming out of the streets of Paris or London where there are no rules. This says no rules.
I like that. I really like that. And I love that you added like the sequins cap.
Just gives it something extra, hey? Like,
yes.
This is all about, we've got the statement choker, she's got the satchel. There's just sort of an effortless coolness about this.
Mm.
So people who want to do the street style can do the little back dress and pull it off.
Okay, so we've now seen workwear, we've now seen weekend street
yes.
style wear. What is your third look?
We are going out for dinner, y'all.
Okay.
Or to like an Oscar party.
Okay.
So this is evening wear, so this is the glam.
Okay.
I think a lot of people think the LBD can't actually work for those glam evenings, that it's a little bit too simple.
Okay.
But again, it's all about the right accessories.
Take it
to the next level. So my three sort of rules for the evening wear LBD, it's all about the clutch.
Okay.
Yeah, clutch. It's all about the block heel.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do nude as well because it offsets the black. It's all about drama with the evening LBD.
Okay.
That really elevates this to the next level. And then a turban, because why not?
Why not? I really like this.
Doesn't it look great?
Yes.
I mean, this can take you sort of drinks with the girlfriends, dinner with your baby boo.
Yes, and all of these things are oh so chic. I really, really love this.
It's really chic, and they're all from Woolworths, which is amazing. So we have all the three girls coming out here.
We're gonna bring all the ladies out. I'm gonna stand up so you guys have the floor. There we go.
So see all three of them here together.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
And it's all different dresses they're wearing, or
no,
the same dress.
No, it's all the same dress.
The same dress,
so that's the
different
cool
ways. Okay,
and
so it's not different black dresses.
Exactly, so it's one dress, three ways.
Mm-hmm.
So this is all about sort of bang for your buck, making the piece sort of last day, night, regardless of style, season. And it's all available at Woolies, this dress and all these sort of style staple pieces.
Oh, I love that. Nick, thank you for joining us and
thank
showing
you.
Us this. I mean, I didn't even realize it was the same dress.
It's the same dress.
The same dress.
Yes.
Absolutely makes sense. It's the same dress. So ladies, there you have it. If you need a workwear outfit, a street style outfit, or even an evening going out, it's all about one little black dress that you can wear three ways. It's my feel-good breakfast show.
So let's go over to something that he really loves even more. It's a very Fashion Thursday here on Expresso. So as we visit Paris Fashion Week for the concluding shows of the spring summer 2018 season, we're going to be taking a look at what happened in Milan and of course venturing to the City of Lights for a final trend report before we kick things into summer officially here in South Africa, and here to ensure that everyone at home has an opportunity to keep it all high fashion. We've got our fashion editor, Nick Strelitz, in the house. house. Are you excited? Did you love what you saw at Paris Fashion Week?
I did. I mean, you know me, every Fashion Week, I'm like running around screaming with my head off.
Just exactly.
So excited.
So excited.
So excited.
Okay, cool. So last week we talked about Milan. Yeah. What are we talking about this morning?
Well, I think we always touch with Fashion Weeks on trends and actual pieces, whether it's dresses or trousers or fabrications. This time I want to talk about accents.
Okay.
So there's an accent of the season and it's the ruffle.
Oh, no wonder. Guys, Nick dresses us. No wonder we were wearing
ruffles.
Is that
a coincidence?
No, I think you planned it like this.
I did plan that. Yes, I did. You look amazing.
So
this season, well, it's all about the accent in the ruffle. So we saw that in shows from Chanel to Giambattista Valli to Alexander McQueen. Quite feminine frill, but paired down with boots. You can grunge it up, you can grunge it down. What I'm very excited about is how we saw the ruffle interpreted in street style.
Okay.
You know it's a trend when people are wearing the trend before they've seen it.
True
on the runway.
Story.
So these
okay.
are all people just wearing the ruffle before they've seen the shows.
Look at the skirt, look at the top.
Right?
Very nice.
And it's understated. The ruffle, I mean, it's been around since the 1500s. I don't know if people know that. Fun fact. So it has a connotation of being a bit outdated.
Yeah.
But you can young it up. Chic it up.
Wonderful. So how do we chic it up and how do we add these trends that we see on the runways in terms of ruffles into our everyday wardrobe?
Yeah, well, I want to show you guys how you can take what you've seen in the catwalks in Paris straight to your closets here in South
Wonderful.
Africa.
Well, show us, darling.
I'm
show
you.
Us.
Come on out.
Model number one.
So you've got Tumi. So it's all about the exaggerated ruffle sleeve.
Yeah.
Now, Woolies is doing this perfectly for the spring-summer season. So we're doing lots of wide flared sleeve. The flared sleeve, harping back to the 70s, is in.
Very nice.
It's an understated ruffle, two-layered ruffle, and look at that sleeve. I mean, you're making
a
statement.
Ah, it's drama. It's
drama.
So much drama.
But
I love it.
Paired with a track pant and trainers, and it's still casual enough to like
Very
roll
cool.
out.
Very
you know?
Cool. Very nice. Yeah. Okay, model number two.
Number two.
I love that sleeve.
Who's gonna
though.
Come around
so
the
nice.
Door?
Ooh la la.
It's Wawa.
This is so beautiful and soft.
And soft. Yeah. So florals. I mean, floral. So it's got the ruffled sleeve. But if you're doing tonal. Yeah. Add in the ruffle as well to give it sort of a slight edge, a little drama. Again, we're seeing it all over sleeves from Woolworths Studio W edition this summer, paired with a just really a deconstructed pant.
Very cool. And that
and
little
a cap.
Sparkly cap, very, very
I
nice.
I like tonal. Tonal, and we're
so
breaking
good.
Up with the black bag, but the ruffle's still the eye-catcher.
Very, very so nice. Let's take a look at our final model this morning.
So final model, we're actually talking makeup trends, Lee. So normally I don't touch on makeup, but I might be wearing some soon, so maybe this. So we've got the
happening?
Ruffle. We've got the ruffle cold shoulder dress, but I want to focus more on the makeup trends which we saw in Paris. So we did two trends of note. We did the coral lip.
Yeah.
So it's goodbye to sort of soft nudes and soft pinks. We're doing sort of a lip that pops. And then look at the pink blush circulating from her cheekbone to the upper brow bone. So this is all about exaggerated. We're talking exaggerated colors, exaggerated blush, exaggerated lip. And she actually pulls it off, right? What do you think?
Very nice. I think she looks gorgeous.
Yeah, the pink's not too
much. With that choker as well, the lace choker.
The choker,
very nice.
It's feminine. Again, these are pieces from Woolies. We're integrating, you know, masculine edges with feminine staples, balancing it out for a perfect look.
Very, very nice. Well, thank you so much, Mr. Strelitz, for keeping us up to date with everything
You're
that's
welcome.
Been happening. It's basically bringing Paris to our wardrobe. And of course, if you would like to know more fashion how-to advice, be sure to download the new Woolworths app. Just SMS the keyword app to 33728 if you are an iOS. And of course, if you are an Android user, then you need to SMS that word play to 33728 and we'll make sure that we keep you updated. It's my feel good breakfast show. Well, ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your sequins hats and your sequins skirts because, of course, it's time for us to find out what's happening in the world of fashion. It's time for the Fashion Fix on Vogue and on trend. And, of course, to help us do that, we've got our fashion Expresso Fashion editor, Nick Strelitz. I just
Girl,
had to get that right, honey.
You get that right.
Get that right. And then, of course,
right,
presenter Tibushi Ntsimunye. How are you doing?
Good.
I just want to let everybody know that I'm going to get it right. Donald Trump style.
Yeah.
Okay.
No,
awesome
you got
stuff.
It. Nailed it.
It's so good to have you guys.
It's nice to see you.
Hey, yes.
Totally, yes.
Okay, Nick, so let's kick off with you. What is trending overseas?
Can I first shout out the fanny pack?
Because
the fanny pack?
Fanny.
Fanny pack.
Okay. Oh.
So but she called this as a trend about 2 weeks ago, and I then bought onto it. So
okay.
I'm following her advice.
Hello. Well done.
There's nothing
done.
In it.
Tabuji is
on it.
She knows what's up. Okay, let's get into some international news.
Please.
So quite a historic moment, actually. On August 1st of this very month, Edward Enninful, British Edward Enninful, did something very, very historic. Mm-hmm. Number one, he was the first person of color and became the first man to helm British Vogue in the 100 years the publication has been around. I mean, this is an iconic moment.
Yes.
Sure. And diva extraordinaire, Naomi Campbell,
ooh, la, la, la,
has actually come out talking about the lack of diversity in the fashion industry big time, but pre-NFL appointment. Pre-NFL appointment. And you don't want to get on the bad side of Naomi. Remember, she hit her assistant with the phone, she threw that at her head. You gotta get a helmet, girl. Anyway, the controversy comes up after a style photo of the editorial team at Vogue was posted on Instagram. Now, this is the style photo taken right before Enninful became editor-in-chief. But look at the faces. Everyone is white. There's not one person of color. 55 people working at the highest echelon of fashion, no one of color. Boo is right.
Hashtag Boo is right. Are white.
So quite controversial. So Naomi's sort of calling it out. She's kind of calling out the previous editor, Alexandra Schulman, who was the editor up until Enninful took the helms of late. So girl better buy a helmet because she's getting a cell phone delivery to her head. So it's a really great moment. You know, people were celebrating diversity. Edwards hired Naomi and Steve McQueen, the director for 12 Years a Slave, to be contributing editors. So things are changing at the top of fashion.
Go Steve! I love him.
Steve.
Necessary.
All right, well, from international to local, there was a big event that was just taking the country by storm.
Absolutely.
What was happening, girl?
As if we don't have enough polos already.
There
was the Inanda Africa polo that took place this Sunday. Which basically celebrated the theme of quintessentially African. And like all polos, it was about the glitz, the glamour, the entertainment, the fashion. And some of our favorite celebrity girls, it girls, were out there. I mean, the likes of Bonang Matheba, who is wearing Orapele Modutli straight from the runway from Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week. So she looks stunning. We also had the likes of Melinda Bam.
I like how you say this name.
The middle.
Is that her last name?
Because that's literally her last name. She's wearing an Alberta. Beautiful dress. I mean, her silhouette is on fleek. And then we also
This was also straight off the runway.
Yeah, straight off the runway. Kuteri and George. This is Dineo Mogates. And she actually won best dress at the polo.
Really?
So really interesting that she's wearing a short dress and she won best dress. And of course, our favorites, Jessica Nkosi and Pearl Tuzi, sneaking in a little cheeky kiss there. It's become like a celebrity signature to like kiss. To get the kids,
just in general. Yeah.
In general life, like
as long as it never becomes Madonna and Britney, I'm happy.
Oh no,
this is cute.
This is fine. We can do with this. Leave so the polo was absolutely amazing, and we'll see what happens next year.
Okay, wonderful. Well, let's talk beauty for a second. What is trending right now?
It's so nice to talk beauty because we never do. And you know, I love a smoky eye. Do I?
You do love
I tell you all the time. I respect
it. You try it every now and then, too.
I do in my closet late at night by myself. So the new trend, so we're used to seeing tattooing. Last year, we saw tattooing of eyebrows.
Yes.
So inserting pieces of actual, tattooed ink to make one's eyebrow appear bigger.
Okay.
Now we're seeing freckles. We're seeing tattooed freckles are now the rich.
Are
you serious, girl?
Levels.
Seeing tattooed freckles. So it's the same technology. It's semi-permanent technology. You can do sort of the sparkly one here. It costs about 3,000 Rand. And some people are saying it's actually permanent.
That's a lot of money.
Some people are saying it's actually permanent, so you consult your doctor first because you don't want to wake up in 40 years and
still have freckles.
Why do I still have these?
But, I mean, you can rock the trend in various ways. You can do a full face. You can do it underneath the eye. And I think people are embracing people with natural freckles, like your Emma Stones, your Eddie Redmayne. And even Alicia Keys, when she was doing the whole no makeup trend, she even had her own natural freckles. So she really embraced that trend.
I love it.
So I don't know, Leanne, would you do fake freckles?
I've got one or two.
Do you?
Underneath the panel meeting, I've got one or two. I'm going to let them shine from now on. Well, it's time for us to, of course, take a little break because when we come back with our fashion squad, we're doing a game of fab or fail. It's my feel good breakfast show. Well, on yesterday's show, we previewed only a sliver of the best from South African Fashion Week, and now it's time for a proper rundown. And if you're a fashion connoisseur interested in the trends soon to sweep the nation, this one's for you. Joining us to help pick the fabs from the fails, Expresso's fashion editor, Nick Strelitz.
Hey! You see what I did with the fabs and the fails?
I'm the only one clapping for you, but it's okay.
Too. No one else in the studio. Everyone's
jealous.
Like, can you stay in Johannesburg?
Well, the thing is, we're all jealous that you got to go to Johannesburg and see the
cool.
opening. Night. Tell us, what was the buzz like?
It was cool. Well, like, I love fashion weeks, as you know. They get me warm and giddy. I won't get into that. But W Beauty and Woolworths obviously sponsored the show, so, like, everyone showed up. It was amazing to see. We saw you know, Benang sitting front row.
Oh, she looked amazing, though.
She looked incredible and terrifying at the same time. Sir John, who we had on the show, obviously, doing all the looks, the beauty looks for W Beauty and for Woolworths. What was even cooler was this whole initiative around sustainability. So Woolworths did this amazing sustainable installation. Look how incredible this is.
Wow, that is so cool.
Every piece in this installation will be reused or recycled, zero wastage. And these cotton slivers from are all raw cotton, which will be donated to the clothing bank to help sort of disadvantaged South African women, sort of to empower. And then obviously the street style. Mm. No fashion weeks without street style.
Absolutely.
And monochrome. Monochrome, quote me, everyone, quote me. Okay. This will be the trend of the season. We saw it from all the influencers, including Nadia Jafta.
Who is now a blonde, a platinum blonde.
Yeah, I didn't recognize her.
I love the look.
I did not recognize her, but she looks incredible. So yeah, it's like all encompassing. It was a great night.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Let's talk trends for a second.
Yes.
Spring, summer 2017.
Yes.
What can we expect to see?
Well, okay, so Woolworths and Style by SA, which we talked about a bit yesterday, was sort of the marquee event. This is where the trends are going to come from for spring, summer. So Woolie showed three capsules in one collection. So I'm going to pull out a trend from each.
All right.
So first was sustainable. Okay. So we talked sustainable fibers. It's cool to care about where your clothes come from now. So Woolworths did this sustainability collection made from better cotton, which means that each piece of cotton in here is dyed using eco-friendly fabrics. So this is, eco-friendly dyes. So it's cool, again, to care about fashion, where your clothes come from. This should be the trend that everyone appropriates because we care so much about what we put inside our bodies. Why not give the same thought to what we actually put on our bodies?
Yeah.
So we'll be sort of pioneering. And look, it's all wearable. I mean, we would wear...
I love each one of these looks.
Yes, yeah.
And I love the colors as well.
And the colors too. Yeah.
Well, I wanted to ask you, you know, Woolworths have been, you know, they've always killed it at SA Fashion Week. What do you think's their secret?
Well, again, like I think they're doing a lot for fashion in South Africa. We talk about sustainability. They partnered with these amazing emerging designers in South Africa, really giving them a leg up. It's all about sort of sustaining enterprises long term. This was their sort of Style by SA campaign video. And they created two other collections. They created a resort collection, which is all about bold prints, sort of holiday sort of attire. And they created a glam collection as well, which is all about sort of how we appropriate nighttime looks now, with sort of a coolness and a sort of street edge. But look how amazing their campaigns are.
Very cool.
It's about competing internationally. We want South Africa to compete on a global scale with the likes of a London, a Paris, Milan, and New York. And Woolworths is really creating content, creating fashion and a message of empowerment that we can compete globally and we can be there competing for a global space for fashion.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much, Nick, for keeping us on
thank
the
you.
Pulse. We
it's
wish
nice
that
to be
we
here.
Were there. We're just happy that you were there keeping us up to date with what's been put down.
Yes, it was
very
great.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much, Nick. Standouts from South African Fashion Week. And it seems like the Woolworths Style by SA capsule collection is the one to beat. Now, if you guys want to get your hands on the season's must-haves, it's possible, and you can do so right now. Shop the newest Style by SA collection in select stores across the nation and online. And you can go to www.woolworths.co.za. You can also check out our Expresso Show Facebook page for a direct link to go and shop now.